The universe is full of odd space activity. From solar storms to disappearing stars, just when we think we have a grasp on what's going on out there, there's something new that pushes the bounds of our understanding. One such discovery was black holes, which are some of the most mysterious and confounding objects in space.
Some people compare a black hole to a celestial zombie. It comes to life anytime something comes too close. It grabs that object in its clutches and never lets go.
The discovery of black holes in 1964 came decades after it was first theorized by Albert Einstein, whose innovative ideas shook up our conception of the universe. Just as we've begun to comprehend the nature of what a black hole is, the power it holds, and the danger it possesses, there comes another major black hole theory that could change everything we know about these bizarre objects.
We can test Einstein's predictions, we can test the theory, just by looking at whether the silhouette is a nice circle. What if the black holes are not really what we think they are? What if Einstein's theory of general relativity that worked so well in the solar system was not exactly right?
How do these black holes differ from the ones we've studied before? How does this discovery alter our understanding of black holes? And what does this mean for us on Earth? You're watching Matter, and here is some unusual activity detected in space that has astronomers baffled. Black holes are one of the most fascinating and intriguing objects that astronomers have found in the vastness of the cosmos. A black hole is a super-dense object that is born after a large star explodes in a supernova while its core collapses in on itself. After they collapse in on themselves, these objects are so dense that it is sometimes called a hole in the fabric of space-time. These terrifying objects are found throughout our universe, and supermassive black holes are found at the center of most galaxies, helping hold its structure together. Black holes are typically very large, ranging in size from 5 solar masses all the way to several billion solar masses. One of the factors that astronomers use to define black holes is the Schwarzschild radius. This radius is the threshold at which the gravity created by the object will cause it to collapse in on itself. The Schwarzschild radius is directionally proportional to the mass of the object, so the more massive the object, the larger the Schwarzschild radius will be. This means that if an object is compressed to the size of its Schwarzschild radius, it will become so dense that it will form into a black hole. Our Sun is huge compared to us and has the mass of 1.989 times 10 to the 30th power kilograms. That's over 330,000 times the mass of the Earth. If scientists wanted to create a black hole with all that mass, they would have to compress it down to its Schwarzschild radius, which would only be 3 kilometers across. Astronomers believe that black holes are formed when stars that are larger than 20 times the mass of our Sun reach the end of their life. As these massive stars die, they will explode in brilliant supernovas, scattering the outer layers of mass out into space. While this explosion is occurring in the outer layers of the star's core begins to collapse in on itself. Eventually, as the core becomes small and dense enough, a new black hole is born. The cores of stars that create black holes are typically greater than 5 solar masses themselves. This gives them enough gravity to collapse smaller than the Schwarzschild radii, forming the black hole. If the mass of the star is less than 20 solar masses and its core is smaller than 5 solar masses, when it dies and its core collapses, the mass left won't create a strong enough gravitational pull to compress it into a black hole, and instead it becomes a neutron star, which are the densest objects that we can see in the universe. But is this the whole story of how black holes are formed, or have astronomers missed out on something along the way? New evidence has come out suggesting that black holes can be much smaller than originally thought, all the way down to the microscopic scale. In recent years, physicists have been theorizing about the existence of black holes smaller than any that have been detected in space. Some of these theoretical black holes are incredibly tiny, on the super microscopic scale. These mini black holes are super hot, reaching temperatures well above any temperature that astronomers have ever found, in the order of billions of degrees Kelvin. Because of their intense heat and minuscule size, these mini black holes evaporate extremely quickly, on the order of a tiny fraction of a nanosecond. But how would these black holes be formed? How could matter get condensed small enough to pass its Schwarzschild radius? Some scientists are worried that if two particles collide into each other while traveling near the speed of light, the amount of force could be enough to form a miniature black hole on Earth. The Large Hadron Collider, or LHC, is the world's largest particle accelerator located in Switzerland, and it is designed to accelerate particles in a massive 27-kilometer loop. It can accelerate protons as close to the speed of light as possible, reaching speeds over 99.99% the speed of light. Once these protons are traveling at insane speeds, they then force two of the protons to collide with each other, creating massive bursts of energy. The whole event only takes a fraction of a second, so they have state-of-the-art equipment to capture every tiny detail of the collision. If these protons strike each other in just the right way, they could theoretically compress to below the Schwarzschild radius and form microscopic black holes. But these mini black holes are so small that they will evaporate almost instantaneously and will not have an effect on life on Earth. While the mini black holes that theoretically could be produced within the Large Hadron Collider pose no threat to us, they are not the only new type of mini black hole being talked about. There may be other types of miniature black holes out there that could pose more of a danger to us in some cases. And if these types of black holes do exist, astronomers' understanding of how black holes form and how they function may need to be revised. How astronomers currently understand the way black holes are formed required that only stars with masses of at least 20 solar masses have enough matter to create forces necessary to collapse into a black hole. But new focus is being pointed towards a black hole that weighs far less than astronomers expect one to weigh. While looking into space one night, astronomers noticed a red giant star orbiting with a partner. But that partner was invisible to them. They knew that there was a second object locked in orbit with the star by studying the orbit of the star, by looking into the gravitational forces acting on the star, so they could also estimate the mass of the invisible object. They also calculated that this mystery object most likely weighs about 3.3 solar masses. This is quite a bit smaller than the minimum mass that a black hole should have, if all the theories on their formation are correct. If this is true, it would go against what many believe about the nature of black holes and their formation. This would lead astronomers to go back and rethink their understanding of the birth of black holes and try to fit this new information into a new explanation. No one knows what this new discovery will lead to and how it may shape the future understanding of our universe. The evidence currently available is pointing towards this object being a black hole, and if this is confirmed, then this will be another piece of information to help astronomers form a complete picture of our universe. It seems that the more data that astronomers collect from outer space, the more questions come up, and occasionally the understanding of the universe's nature needs to be revised. Would the existence of these mini black holes change the way you look at the universe? Or are they just another thing that makes our universe so intriguing? If you watched all the way to the end, we want to say thank you for watching, and if you enjoyed this video, please feel free to hit the like and subscribe buttons so you won't miss out on any of our future videos.